Yo, what's up? So basically, I'm just trying to walk through how I made the beat for No Sunshine, which is on my channel, and how and why I use the plugin Stereo Shaper in FL Studio to do that. All right, so first things first, we can just play the sample that I use for the track. Alright, cool. So that was pretty much the main section that I used for most of the track. There were a couple other chops from like different sections, but we can get into that later. So let me show you the chops that I made in FPC and show you how I sequenced the track first. Alright, cool. So here you can see FPC, which is pretty much like the pads for FL Studio. I've got my different chops in there. I can just play a couple just to show you. And like when I'm making a track, I usually just go by taking like the chops that I like. I don't really have too much of an idea of what the ending track is gonna sound like, if that makes sense. So I'm just kind of like playing around with the chops that I like to see if I can find a sequence really. So let me show you the sequence that I made with that. All right, cool. So here is the sequence that I made from that. It's a bit choppy, which I fixed later, but this is like the rough idea that I made with like the chops that I did. So this was the last bit of the chops as well. I sequenced it a little bit differently because it was like a turnaround bit, but let me just play it real quick. Alright, so that bit basically leads back into the original chops that I showed you at the beginning. Alright, cool. So if we go back to the sample and I just play it real quick. So if you're wearing headphones, you can hear that in the left channel, like it's all right, but in the right channel, there's like a lot of bongos, a lot of different drums going on. So it was like when I was making a track, it was like I want what's in the left channel more than I want what's in the right channel, if that makes sense. But like when you're working with samples, right, it's kind of hard to get exactly what you want sometimes because it's not like you can go back to the original recording room or whatever and just like, I don't know, re-record it. You kind of have to work with what you're given, if that makes sense. So I pretty much wanted what's in the left channel more than the right. So to do that, I used a plugin in FL Studio called Stereo Shaper. If you use a different DAW, you probably have a similar thing, but let me just show you what that is real quick. All right, so it's a plugin that looks a little bit like this. So I'm gonna play the sequence again, just a little bit with it turned off, and then I'm gonna play it again with it turned on so you can kind of see what happens. If you wear headphones, it's easier to hear on what's going on, so I do recommend that if you have them around. So yeah, I'm gonna just play that real quick. Right, so I'm gonna turn it on and let's see what it sounds like. So when I turn it on, you can see that the bongos in the right side of the channel are kind of like laid down in the mix. It's not so much as to that they're turned off, but it's easier to lay my own drums over it, and there's like less of a groove going on that's distracting in the right channel, which is what I wanted for this particular beat. I'm no expert in how it works, but let me try and show you like kind of what I did if I reset it real quick. When you originally like open the plugin, this is what it's gonna look like. It's gonna have the yellow bar and the red bar. Okay, so as I said, the yellow bar and the red bar, the left and right channels. So if you lower one, for example, if I lower the yellow one, you'll hear that the left signal is gone in the stereo field. So let me do that real quick and play it again. You should be able to hear like it's only playing in the right channel. Let me do the opposite. So if I lower the red one, you can hear that it's only playing in the left channel. So what I did was I lowered the right channel, and then if you see there's like another knob to the right, it's yellow. So if I raise that one, it's gonna like duplicate the left signal into the right channel, so it's not only playing in one ear, if that makes sense. So when I play it now, it just sound like both channels are filled. So pretty much to get the chop sounding less choppy, I guess, what I did is I just bounced them to audio so I could put them on the track here. And I just took the bits that weren't really on time great, or had like little gaps of silence in between, and I just took those bits and stretched them so there's not really that silence in between the chops. So let me just show you that one time. Yeah, so you can see now it's all on time and whatnot. All I needed to do next was just add the drums and the bass line, really. So the drums are pretty much like that throughout most of the track, apart from the turnaround, which I think I changed the bass line just to go along with the sample a bit more. Okay, so let me play like the first bit of the track and the last bit of the track with the drums so you can see what it sounds like now. So yeah, that was pretty much just like a little breakdown video of the track. You can find the full track on my channel. It's called No Sunshine. If you want to check it out, I'll link it in this video. I'll link it in the description as well. I might do some more of these in the future as well. Just some like little tips and tricks that I've learned in FL Studio. Again, like I'm using FL. You can use any DAW. You'll probably find something similar. You know what I mean? So yeah, man, that's pretty much it.